Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate you how we can set up page layout in Salesforce Lightning. If you want to follow Salesforce training videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta on YouTube and you can follow my YouTube channel. So now coming on to the topic, we are going to discuss about page layout in Salesforce Lightning. So I have one object that is book, and for that book object, I am going to set up page layout. So you need to open the object from Object Manager, and here you will see the page layouts option. So you need to click on this link, and on right hand side, you will see page layout. So by default, one page layout will be available for each object. And if you want to create new, you can also do that. So let me first open my university app. Here book tab is available. And if I open any existing record, you will see it is not having a proper page layout. Like all the fields are available in single column and only 3-4 fields are available on second column. Right, and no section is available. So right now we are going to arrange these fields and we are going to create some sections. And also you can see only one related list is available here. So we will also understand how we can add more related list for this. So now moving to setup again, I am going to open this book layout. So at the top, you can see several options are available: fields, button, quick action, mobile and lightning actions, expanded lookups, related lists, report charts. So these many options are available that you can set up in page layout. So right now we are going to focus upon fields. So if I click on fields, so at right hand side, all available fields for this book object will be available. And you can see all fields are disabled because they are already available on the page layout. So let's say discount is not available. So it will be marked as highlighted, right? So if you want to place this, you just need to drag and drop it on the layout, right? And if you want to remove any field from the layout, you can just drag and drop it back to top. Or you can simply click on this remove sign, right? So let me first arrange these fields and create section. Then we will discuss more about this page layout thing. So let me create one section. So here, section name will be author information. Layout will be two column. And you can select the tab key order, left to right and top to down. Then display section header on. So if you want to display this name both on detail page and edit page, then you can choose both the checkboxes and you can click on OK. So here you can see author information section is created. Right? Now I am going to move author related fields in this section. So you can see I moved three fields. Those were related to author. Now I'm going to create one more section. That is price information. And selecting two column layout, tab key order will be left, right, left to right, and then it will be available on detail and both edit page. So now I'm going to move price related information here. So you need to simply drag and drop the fields in the desired location. Now book details, so book number, book name, then list of content, about book, then technical category, category available in which country, then this is student detail. So this way I created three sections. First is default, that is information. Second is author information. Third is price information. And fourth one is system information. This is also default, which shows created by and last modified by fields, right? So here you can see this information header visible on edit only. So if you want to change the setting of any section, so you can click on this section properties and you can click here and click on OK. So now it will be available on detail page as well, right? So let me first save it. So you can click on quick save and you can check changes by refreshing your page, record detail page. So you will see a new layout will be available as per the design we created. So this is the information section, then author information, price information, and you can see accordions are available. If you click here, you can minimize these sections as well, right? So this way these sections are available. If we click on edit, so on edit window, these sections are also available and you can see fields are arranged as per the layout. So it is pretty interesting and it changed the look and feel of the detail page, right? Now, if you want to set a particular field required read only from layout level, so you can click on these checkboxes. So you can either make read only or make required from the page layout, right? So if we suppose about book, if you make it required from page layout and click on OK, so this red asterisk will be available. It means it is required now. So you need to fill the details. So from page layout, you can also make fields required as well as read only. So suppose you want to make this field read only, you can click OK. So now this field will be read only. You can see a lock is available here. So this way you can modify the properties of fields also from the page layout. So right now I'm removing these. Then at the bottom we can add related list. So I'm leaving all these options because these will be covered in respective topic. Right now we don't have anything for these topics. So I'm directly moving to related list. So here you can see book histories, activity history, and open activities. These three related lists are available. So activity is available at right hand side and book history is available here. Now, if you want to add more related lists which are available in approval history, book history, content deliveries, files, groups, notes and attachments, related content. So let's say notes and attachment I want to add after book history. Then files, then approval history, right? So this way I drag and dropped three related lists and I'm clicking on quick save, clicking on yes. So let's see whether these related lists will be available or not. So I'm doing a refresh. Clicking on related, you can see all the related lists are available now. Sorry. So first one is book history, second one is notes and attachments, third is files, and fourth one is approval history. So this way you can add a related list also. So if you are creating lookup and master detail fields, then those related lists will be available there. Automatically while creating those fields if you check the particular checkbox. Otherwise you can simply drag and drop them from the page layout also. So now finally we can click on save if you don't want to change anything. Then we have preview as also. Then we have cancel button. Then we have layout properties. So if you want to change the name of layout, then you want to select highlight panel show in the console. You want to select interaction logs, so you can check these checkboxes, right? So I hope you understood about page layout thing, how we can set up different fields and sections, and how we can add related list. So if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can search my name, Sanjay Gupta, on YouTube, and you can follow my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching this video.